Hello children, I am Prasanna. I am going to teach you about quadrilateral in this video. Okay. Now in the previous video I have discussed a simple closed figure formed by three line segments is nothing but a triangle. Here coming to quadrilateral. In the name itself we are having children. Here quad. Quad means what? Four. Okay. And lateral means what? Sides. Okay. Here four sides. A figure with four sides. That too simple closed figure formed by four line segments is known as quadrilateral. Okay. Now a simple closed figure. Formed by four line segments is called a quadrilateral. Now, so it is having four sides and it is a closed figure, isn't it? Now, here I'll name the figure first. Here A, B, C, D. Okay. Now here A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. And what are the line segments here? Like triangle. Here you are having four line segments and four vertices and four angles. Okay. Now I am going to write all whatever parts of the quadrilaterals are there here. Okay. And first one in that sides. Sides are nothing but line segments, right? So here you are having four sides, that is AB, BC, CD, DA. These are the four sides. AB, BC, CD, DA. Next vertices. Now before vertices, how you read this quadrilateral, children? You can write in so many ways. Here we can see, suppose take this small symbol as a quadrilateral and we can represent this as quadrilateral ABCD, right? Or you can represent quadrilateral ADCB. See, with A, ABCD I can go, or ADCB I can write. I can't write ACBD here. The continuation should be there, children. You should not write like a quadrilateral A, B, B, C. This is wrong. Because here you are missing the chain. Here A, D, B. You are coming like this. No. Continuation should be there. And some, if you write like this, A, B, B, C. Is that correct, children? Just now I explained. So you can't write la. Can I write quadrilateral B, A, C, D? B, A, C, D. Can I write like that? No, here chain is missing. You can write B, A, D, C. Quadrilateral B, A, D, C. So the continuation should be there. So in this way you can represent a quadrilateral in so many ways. Now, what are the vertices? Coming to vertices, vertices are nothing but the corners. Here A comma B comma C comma D are the four vertices. Next, coming to angles. Here you are having four angles. So angle A comma angle B comma angle C comma angle D. Here you can represent either with single letter or with the three letters. Okay. Next, coming to diagonals. Now tell me, what is diagonal? Diagonal is nothing but a line segment joining the two opposite vertices. Here A and C are what? Opposite. If I join these two, you are going to get a diagonal. Okay. And coming to here, B and D are the opposite vertices. If I join these two, I am going to get another diagonal. See, diagonal is nothing but a line segment joining opposite vertices. So here, how many diagonals you are getting, children? Here two diagonals. They are nothing but AC and BD. The two diagonals. So quadrilateral is having four sides, four vertices, four angles and four diagonals, right? And still we are going to write here what are opposite sides. opposite, pair of opposite sides. Pair of opposite sides. Here I can write. Pair means you know. Now if you observe, AB is opposite to DC. Right? Can I write? AB and DC are opposite sides. AB and DC are one pair of opposite sides. Next, if I see AD and BC also opposite. So another pair is nothing but AD and BC. Okay? So you are going to get two pairs of opposite sides in a quadrilateral. Once again, I am explaining, AB is opposite to DC and AD is opposite to BC. So you are going to get two pair of opposite sides. Okay? Next, coming to opposite angles. Pair of opposite angles. Here, what is the opposite angle of AC? So, angle A and angle C are opposite angles. Yes. Next, what is the opposite of angle B, children? Angle D. So, one more pair is nothing but B and D. Here also, you are going to get two pairs of opposite angles. Next, we are going to write pair of adjacent sides. See, for opposite sides, you are going to get two pairs, but for adjacent sides, you are going to get four pairs. Adjacent means side by side, okay? Here, if you see, AB is adjacent to BC, isn't it? AB is adjacent to BC. Next, BC is adjacent to CD. Here, BC is adjacent to CD. Next, CD is adjacent to DA. Yes? Next, DA is adjacent to AB. So, here you are going to get four pairs of adjacent sides. Now, here we are going to write pairs of adjacent angles. Okay? Coming to here, angle A is adjacent to angle B. Angle A and B are adjacent. Yes? And B and C are adjacent. So, angle B is adjacent to angle C. C and D are adjacent. Angle C is adjacent to angle D. Next, angle D and A are adjacent. So, angle D and angle A are adjacent. Here, if you observe, a quadrilateral is having four sides, four vertices, four angles, two diagonals, and two pairs of opposite sides, two pairs of opposite angles, four pairs of adjacent sides, and four pairs of adjacent angles. Next, once again, I am taking quadrilateral ABCD, children. Here, is it a regular or irregular figure? What is mean by regular? Regular means all sides and angles are equal. Regular means all sides and angles are equal. And what is irregular? Irregular is nothing but opposite to regular. All sides and angles are not equal. So, based on sides and angles, we can divide a quadrilateral into different types. That we are going to learn in types of quadrilaterals, children. Coming to quadrilateral, a quadrilateral can be regular or irregular. And what about these angles? Here, you know, in the triangle, some of the interior angles in a triangle is how much? 180 degrees. Then what about this quadrilateral? In quadrilateral, we are having a four angles. Angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. Okay? Then what is the angle here? I am taking all the interior angles here. The sum of all the interior angles of a quadrilateral is how much? 360. For triangle, you know it is 180, and for the quadrilateral, you are having 360 degrees. So, sum of all interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Like triangle, suppose this is a plane, any figure means here if I am taking a quadrilateral, quadrilaterals divide this plane into three parts, that is interior of the quadrilateral, exterior of the quadrilateral and boundary of the quadrilateral. So quadrilaterals divides the plane into three parts: interior of the quadrilateral, exterior of the quadrilateral, and the boundary of the quadrilateral. See, in objective, there you may get the questions like this, children. Here, if they ask the side opposite to AB is what? The side opposite to AB. What is the side opposite to AB here? DC, isn't it? Right? And what is the side opposite to BC? What is the side opposite to BC here? AD. Yes? And what is the side opposite to CD? AB. And what is the side opposite to DA? CB. Right? Or sometimes you may get the opposite angle. The opposite angle of angle A. What is the opposite to angle A here? It's very easy, angle C. Angle opposite to B, angle D. In reverse, what is the angle opposite to C? Angle A. Angle opposite to D, angle B. Yes, now coming to adjacent sides of AB. So you are going to get two adjacent sides. If you see, children, here opposite of AB is what? DC. So quite opposite. These two are opposite. Here opposite of AB is DC, isn't it? Then what are the adjacent sides of AB? The other than opposite. Here CD is opposite. The other two sides are left over is what? AD and BC. Means the line segments which are touching to that line segments, children. Here the adjacent sides of AB is nothing but AD and BC. Okay? AD and BC. AD and BC are the two adjacent sides of AB. Now, can you say what are the adjacent sides of BC here? This is the opposite. The other two sides are what? BA and CD. BA and CD are the two adjacent sides of BC. Now, can you say what are the adjacent sides of CD? Leave that opposite. CB and DA are adjacent sides of CD. Now, what are the adjacent sides of DA here? If you take DA, CB is the opposite side. So, DC and AB. DC and AB are the adjacent sides of DA. Now, coming to the last one, adjacent angles of angle A. See, for angle A, what is the opposite angle? C. So, what are the leftover angles here? B. B is adjacent to A and D is also adjacent to A. So, what are the adjacent angles of A here? Angle B and angle D. Now, can you say what is the adjacent angle of B here? C and A. Angle C and angle A. And what are the adjacent angles of angle C? Is nothing but angle D and angle B. Now, what are the adjacent angles of angle D? Is nothing but angle A and angle C. Means the other angles which is not opposite. If you see, the opposite angle of angle D is what? Angle B. Other than B, what are the other leftover angles? C and A. So, the adjacent angles of angle D are nothing but angle A and angle C.